Zofunda umbalo.
It says, First Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4.
Abase Korinte bokuqala isahluko seshuminandathu inima yeshuminambili.
For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in past, but then I shall know even as I am known. Let us pray. Our heavenly Father, we thank you for the reading of the word, Lord Father, because we know a blessing is in store, is locked in every scripture. May you come, Lord, with your spirit and unlock the riches of the scriptures that we have read to empower your children. May the spirit of the author come out of the pages of the Bible to attend to the present tense needs of your children, that Father, they will see evidently, Lord, that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. They will see your hand prevailing and winning their battles, crushing the arm of the devil. Heavenly Father, I pray that you visit your people in various needs with the baptism of the Holy Spirit and deliverance and salvation and healing and your power to emancipate them from their conditions. That Father, the service, Lord Father, will be followed by the supernatural and phenomena. I pray, committing everything into your hands in Jesus' name. Amen. We may be seated. Here Paul says, we shall know as I shall know as I'm known. There is part of our knowledge that is still lacking in us. Each one seems to know themselves the way they think they are. You seem to know yourself the way you think. Or you have been influenced to think you are. Something from happenings around your life. But then you shall know as you are known. In heaven, you are not known as a defeated Christian. You are not known as a failure. But there is a purpose that God has put to you on earth. Rahab was known as a harlot, but in heaven, she was known as an ancestor of Christ. The woman at the well was known as a prostitute. In heaven, she was known as a soul winner. Lygion was known as a demoniac.
Oh, Lygion, but
in heaven, he was known as a follower of Christ. Maybe Jephthah was known as a son of a harlot. But in heaven, he was known as a captain. Joshua, the high priest with dirty garments.
Joshua,
but he was a firebrand snatched from the fire. When Gideon was running away from Midianites, in heaven he was known as a mighty man of valor. You must be aligned with your theophany, aligned with the revelation of your potential. The dry bones were not known as dry bones in the
valley.
They were known as the army of the Lord, and they were going to rise to be what they are known to be. You shall know as you are known. You must say, for such a time as this came into the world. I'm preaching about discovering the purpose of your existence. There must be a purpose in your life. I believe in living a purpose-driven life. A word-driven life. A Holy Spirit driven life. A faith driven life. A success driven life. An inspiration driven life. A life powered by the supernatural. A revelation driven life. You must discover the reason of your very existence. There is a mystery why you were born. There is a mystery why you are still alive. There is a mystery why you look different. You are not like another person. There is a reason why you pass through what others did not pass through. It was the shaping of a vessel. If you go to the temple of God, you found some vessels are furnished. They are designed to carry the oil. There are other vessels that are furnished.
Ezinye ezinesimo esingazwiseki zilungiselelwe ukuthwala amalahle amalahle avuthayo ngomlilo. Was good
there are some vessels that are designed to carry the
nations.
There are some vessels that are designed to carry the waters. There are some vessels that are designed to carry the
insides.
But each vessel has a funny shape.
Sonke isitsha sinesimo esingazisekiyo esinesizathu esilungele sona. Nga usivumbulula leso sizathu.
It will be like until then you never leave.
Kuzoba ngathi kuze kufike leso sikhathi ubungaphili.
You are starting your life right now.
Ngathi uqala impilo yakho njengamanje.
There are many things that you discover.
Kukhona izinto ezinengi ozivumbululayo.
It's never too late to discover.
Ngamanye amaxesha akusikho late ukuthi ukuvumbulule.
Discovered the formula he was 8 years.
Umose evumbulula iformula ebeneminyaka engamashumi asibhozo.
A new 40-page life.
Wabhala impilo enamakhasi awu 40.
When he was 40 years,
eseneminyaka ewu 40,
he discovered the pillar of fire.
Wavumbulula insika yomlilo.
And he went back to meet Pharaoh.
Wabuyela kufa.
When he was 120 years,
eseneminyaka elikhulu enamashumi amabili,
he was still having the same force.
Ebesese namandla nomfutho ofanayo.
It was not late for him at 8 years to
meet God. Bekungekho late kuye ukuthi
gcwalise isizathu. Why you pass through?
Kunesizathu udlula kulokho odlula kukho.
There's a reason why you carry the pain. Kukhona
isizathu. Amen.
Because there is something invested in you.
Ngoba kukhona ukuthiwe okuthile okuhlanyelwe kuwe.
There is a reason why God called you that
day. Khona isizathu uThixo ekubize ngalolo suku.
When there were billions of people in the
world. Lapho khona izigidi zabantu emhlabeni.
There is a reason why you are unique.
Khona isizathu kungani uhlukene.
There is a reason why the devil hates you.
Khona isizathu Satan ekuzonda nje.
You need to discover the full.
Umele uvumbulule ngokupheleleyo.
Purpose of your existence.
Isizathu sokuphila kwakho.
So that you can trim off the irrelevant.
Khona ukuze ukwazi ukuhlukana nezinto ezingalungelanga. Ungeke ulahlekelwe ngamandla awukushiya izinto ezingenasizathu. Khona isizathu uThixo ngeke akudele. Khona isizathu wena ungeke azidele nje. Noma ngensuku lapho bekunzima.
God actually knew that you were not going to give up.
Ebeyazi ukuthi awusozi udele.
There is a reason why God will never substitute you. Because in this whole church and the overseas, there is no one who can take your place.
Apesha kwezilwandle.
Even no, there is not even an angel.
Oma lapho kungena.
Not an angel who can take your place.
Noma kungena ngelo sengathatha indawo.
He has put you higher than the angels.
Ukubeke ngaphezulu kwe.
There is a reason why God invested so much in you.
Kukhona isizathu sokuthi kani uThixo efake okuthile ku.
He put his spirit in you.
Ubeke umoya wakho ngcwe.
He put his message in you.
Ubeke umbiko wakhe.
And all what was in God he poured into Christ. And all what was in Christ he poured into you.
Donke ubeke ku Jesu Christ kubeke kuwe.
God invested a lot in you.
Ubeke
okuwe. And God is not a poor investor.
Futhi uThixo akasomhlanye.
He cannot put something where he can lose.
Angeke afake okuthile lapho kungamlahlekela khona.
He cannot save you to lose you.
Angeke akugcinele ukuthi umlahlekele.
He has put all his promises on you.
Ubeke izethembiso zakhe zonke kuwe.
He has put all what you need up to the
rapture. Ubeke konke okudingayo ukuthi ungene kuhlutshweni phakathi kwakho.
The powers of the world to come in.
Ukunikeze amandla ezwe elizayo.
He has made you possessors of all things.
Ukwenze ube ngumthumbi wento zonke.
He has put the soul life of God in you.
Ubeke impilo engcwele kaThixo ngaphakathi kwakho.
He has put his DNA in you.
Inhlamvu kaThixo kuye.
He has put even Christ in you, the hope of glory.
First, ithemba lenkazimulo
kuwe. He has put divine potentials in you.
Amandla ayinqaba kuwe.
God cannot just invest all these things.
Angeke ahlanyele zonke into zakhe nje.
When there is no return.
Mahlayana nje kungekho
kuphendukayo. When there is nothing certain.
Kungenanzuzo kungenanto enesiqiniseko.
About you in your life.
Kuwe empilweni yakho.
There must be a mystery.
Kufuneka kube khona insumansumane.
Why the offering is magnetized to you.
Amen.
Why your theophany is magnetized?
Lapho umzimba wakho udonselwa ngakho.
It must be a mystery why God is.
Kumele kube khona imfihlakalo ukuthi kungani uThixo enesikhwele ngakuwe.
One of the names of God is jealous.
Elinye lamagama kaThixo nguThixo onesikhwele,
ujealous. When you are reading those dirty magazines.
Ujealous nxa ubala amagazini angcolile.
Jealous when you are listening to those music.
Ujealous nxa ulalela umculo ongcolile.
But there must be a mystery why he's jealous.
Onimfihlelo ukuthi kungani nesikhwele.
I'm jealous over you.
UPaul uthi nginesikhwele.
That I may present to you as a chest virgin.
Ukuthi nginibeke njengentombi into engenamsolwa.
Do anything and God is not jealous.
Kukhona abangenza noma yini uThixo angabe.
But there must be something that you discover as a mystery.
Kodwa kumele kube khona ukuthile ozokuvumbulula njengemfihlelo.
An eye over you.
Uthi Thixo ngane beke.
Even when you are sick at impilo, he keeps an eye over you.
Noma ugula usesibhedlela impilo ubeka iso lakhe kuwe.
Noma ungenanto
yokudla endlini ubeka iso lakhe kuwe.
Even when you are sleeping the night, he keeps an eye
over
you.
Noma ulele ezizulwini zobusuku uyabheka.
His eye is on the sparrow.
Iso lakhe liyang.
And I know he watches over me.
Futhi ngiyazi ungibhekile.
There must be a mystery why there is a hard training about
you. Kumele kube khona imfihlelo yokuthi kungani uvivinywa ngokulungiselelo
kunjani. Brother, some through the water, some through the blood.
Osudlule kukhomzalwa abanye emanzini abanye emlilweni.
It defines a mystery of why God is investing so much.
Kuletha insingiselo yokuthi kungani uThixo ehlanyele kungaka kuwe.
If you see an elephant having an 18 month pregnancy.
Nga ubona indlovu ikhulelwe okwenyanga ezishumi
eminesishiyagalombili.
Lapho izinja nje zikhulelwe okwesikhashana esincane nje zibele zibe nabadlwana.
When an elephant is born you will see the reason for the
weight. Nga indlovu isikhululekile uzabona isizathu sokuthi kungani.
There's been a long wait for that great final.
Bekukhona ukumelelwa okukhulu.
There's been a long wait for that great climax.
Bekukhona ukulindela okukhulu okwenqonga enkulu.
Because the saints of Hebrews 11 are waiting.
Ngokuthi abangcwele baba eBheru.
They without us.
Bathi bona ngathi nasingekho abaphelelanga.
And all nature was waiting.
Yonke imvelo ibilindile.
For the manifestation.
Ilindele ukubonakaliswa.
Of the sons of God.
Abantu bana bakaThixo.
Even those who are in the sixth dimension. They are waiting on this. There is a reason for the great climax that is about to show. When you shall be surprised about who you are. Oh, brother, there is a lot you can discover
for yourself.
Even this Zimbabwe, as old as it
normal
is,
Zimbabwe
is still discovering it as oil. Sometimes it takes a man from far.
Off.
There must be an invictor spiritually.
Kumele kube khona
that will say these people are sitting on potential.
Abantu laba bahlezi ngaphezu kwamandla
okuqhubeka. When people of Marange were busy plowing,
abantu basemarange belima amagwili.
They didn't know the diamonds under their soils.
Bebengazi amadayimani angaphansi komhlabathi wabo.
When they discovered that, it changed their lives.
Lapho bevumbulula lokho kwaguqula impilo zabo.
When you discover who you are,
awuvumbulula ukuthi wena ubani.
In heavenly terms.
Ngezindlela
not in financial terms. Not in positions. Not in status. I want you to upgrade your status today. Not on WhatsApp or Facebook, but in heavenly terms.
Facebook.
You shall know as you are known. That's why
I have
no time for discouragement. Because the picture in God's hand. Does not call for sorry or pity party. We are not here to float and drift. We are not here to be average.
To
say, brother, as long as I'm making
it,
no.
Paul
as high as he was.
Paul ephezulu njengalapha bekhonzo wabakhona uthi khona into eyodwa
ngiyenza
khohle izinto ezidlule.
I press to the mark.
Ngiyaqhubeka
no matter how high you get.
Noma sengiphezulu kangakanani
sesekhona
indawo ephezulu elungiselwe wena.
A better version of yourself.
See,
that's why someone said
yingakho othile wathi
I'm not what I used to be. Yet I'm not what I'm supposed to be.
There's
been some mileage somehow.
But
I'm not yet content. Because something keeps holding me. Throwing me constantly. It's a reality. More real than what you are. We are not here to celebrate the past. I'm not celebrating what I've done big in the past. But I'm looking at the promises
afar
off. And I embrace them. And I start confessing. I'm becoming one with what is written. When Christ says, the Son of Man goeth as it is written of me. I discovered I also go as it is written of me.
Njenga lo akong kubalwe nga.
It is written of me.
Kubaliwe nga mi.
Those that know their God.
Labo mamazi uthixo wabo.
Shall do exploits.
Bazokwe.
Explore the potentials of your life.
Bazo vumbulula kuningi kwamandla
empilo. You are not here to be a spectator.
Asikho lapho kuzobukela.
But you are here to be spectacular.
Kodwa ulapho ukuthi uzophakanyiselwa.
You are here to be an expectant.
Ulapho ukuthi uzoba ngumkhangeleli.
God can turn the tables.
Uthixo angaguqula
ubufakazi bempilo
yakho.
Khona
isizathu uthixo wakhetha wena emulini yakho.
Torchbearer of the whole family.
Ukuthi ube ngumphathi wesigodi empilweni.
Every Sunday you are here. There is a reason why something keeps coming in your life. You are not here to complain.
You are not here to be a beggar.
They say you have nothing. But they are so wrong. You must prove that you are one in a million. You are not here to dance to the devil's tune. You are not here to cop other sisters. But you are here to be who you are.
Kodwa ngilapho kuzoba ngulo engiwuye.
I have no time to be somebody else.
Anginasikhathi sokuba ngomunye umuntu.
I have no time to admire somebody
else. Andinalo ixesha lokukhangela omunye umuntu.
I have a lot to admire about me here.
Yinokuningi okokuzibuka ngami.
You must discover scriptures that define
you. Umele uvumbulule imbhalo enika intsingiselo yakho.
Like that woman who says, I is the Shunammite woman.
Othi
who are you in the Bible? Is there David today? Because there are more than Goliaths. Is there a Hannah today? Because there are more than Peninnas. Is there Mordecai today? Because there are more than Hamans.
Paul says,
I am what I am by the grace of God. It's not because of the school I went to. It's not because of the family I was born in. But this thing called the grace of God. It has defined my life. It was grace that led me save this far. And grace will lead me home. You are not defined by your past. You are not defined by your abilities.
Jeremiah
was born to be a prophet. He became a prophet. Father Abraham was born a leader. No cabin or whatever. Whether he had shoes or no shoes. He was going to be a leader. If God has put you something you to be a preacher. Even if you are poor, you shall be a super, a good preacher. Your gift will make a room. Because you are anointed to become what you are to be.
Here
was designed not to have lips because it's not going to speak.
But it's going
to help you to listen before you speak. Your little finger here
may
not be like the thumb.
Ah, azanga lungisele lwe
njenga fold ministry.
You see,
evangelist to remain evangelist.
Umvangeli uzoba
umvangeli. Teachers remain teachers.
Umfundisi uzoba ngumfundisi.
Pastors will become pastors.
Umalusi abe ngumalusi.
Apostles apostles.
Umposteli abe
ngumposteli. Prophets, they are designed that way.
Ulungisi.
And mothers are designed that way.
Nabo mama balungiswe ngaleyo ndlela. Abo baba balungiswe ngaleyo ndlela.
The design that you are did not come from the earthly dimension. It came from the heavenly dimension. Brother, if you are sick, do you know that if my car is a Toyota, if I go to Toyota, they have spare parts for
spare parts.
If you are from God and your kidneys just crash,
put in so
you must go back somewhere.
Spare
parts for your life. Brother, you may not despise small people. If you look at a tractor, you may say it is not faster than a Benz.
E320
somewhere there. But take them and put them in a maize field.
You
will see that a tractor is faster. The Benz will be just skidding like that. Everyone has a field.
When
did you put them? Know that for such a time, because they are designed. I was at the airport one day. I saw some little cars. You never see them on the road. They are just designed to go underneath and take your bags. They are designed to take people to
unemployment.
You will never see them on this road. And when your purpose is done, that's the only time you are taken off. Sometimes when you have done your part, give way to other people to do their part. When a caterpillar starts the road, it knocks all the trees. But when the road is okay, we don't want the caterpillar. It will destroy the road. When you see the caterpillar on the road, it will be on top of another car, saying abnormal load. Because it's loaded with potential. When apostles are through, they put pastors in positions. Then the abnormal Lord moves to another place to knock the trees. You will never have the sprinklers before the caterpillar has done its part.
That's why God says,
first apostles, then prophets. Because before you even introduce the prophet, you must go out there. That is the missionary first.
Okuyinkundla missionary.
Everyone is peculiar. Wonke umuntu
wahlukile ngendlela
ethile. Judge a fish.
Kunxa ungahlulela inhlanzi.
By his ability to climb a tree.
Ngokwanelisa kwayo ukugada
isihlahla. He spend his whole life thinking he's stupid.
Impilo yayo yonke icabanga ukuthi ngikungaphelele
kusangani.
Izatha mina ngingomehluleke.
If you judge a monkey,
ungahlulela inkawu.
By his ability to swim.
Ngokwanelisa kwayo ukudada emanzini.
It will feel like it's a failure.
Izabona sengathi
ikwehluleka. Why you thought you were failing?
Kungani ucabanga ukuthi ungumuntu
owehluleka?
Ngoba ubuzama ukwenza.
What is not your part?
Okungayisikho ndima yakho.
Let that revelation.
Isambulelo esikhulu.
Why you were born strike you?
Sokuthi kungani wazalwa
sikushaya nje. Why you was born?
Samson wazi ukuthi ungane
ezelwe. When he hears that Philistines finish something.
Esizwa ukuthi amaFilistine
afikile.
Wayephakama ethi bangapi?
Until the brothers say. When he went to attack the Philistines,
they said,
don't you know that Philistines rule over us?
Says,
I don't know. You are the ones who know that.
But
me, I was born to destroy them. But it's a pity
Kotwa ngolusizi.
When you see yourself ruled by what you were born to.
Nxa usuzibona ubuswa yilokho ozalelwe ukuthi ukubuse.
Samson was now under the Philistines.
Ah, uSamson esengaphansi kwamaFilistine.
That he was born to destroy.
Abezalelwe ukuthi awabhidlize.
Sometimes the devil has brainwashed.
Ngamanye amaxesha uSatan yakuphumputhekisa
nje. So they don't know their potential.
Ukuze ungakwazi amandla akho.
You are brainwashed when you think you are a failure.
Uyaphumputhekiswa ukuthi ucabanga ukuthi ngumuntu wokuhluleka.
You have a divine assignment.
Kodwa unes Smiselo
esinqaba
Smiselo sethu ukuthi simbizwe
uDevil. We are the devil's official enemy.
Sisitha esisemthethweni sika Satan.
Our purpose is to live by every word.
Isizathu sethu ukuphila ngalo lonke
izwi. It was not a small thing.
Mzalwane bengase yonto encane
nje. God quit dealing with men in Genesis 6.
Lapho uThixo esima ukusebenza no nabantu ku Genesis.
My spirit shall not thrive with men.
Wathi umoya wama usozu namathela abantu.
Because they tried to live by the way they all failed, even Abraham's failed.
Ngoba bazame ukuphila ngendlela futhi bonke behluleka Abraham, Joseph nabo bonke.
But God raised one man, Jesus Christ.
Kodwa uThixo waphakamisa indoda ethile nguYesu Christ. Owaphila ngalo lonke izwi.
He was not the last born.
Wae
ngaso. He was the first born of the creation of God.
Elizibulo lendalo ka
Thixo. There are people almost everywhere.
Manje khona abantu mhlawumbe indawo yonke. Abanenhliziyo ezivutha ngomlilo. Kamoya ngcwele ofanayo.
The difference is quantity not quality.
Eh umehluko nje yisilinganiselo hathi
when the Holy Ghost baptizes you.
Umoya ngcwele xa ekubhabhathisa.
It's a great condensation.
Good condensation enkulu.
Because it means that God will be in that heart.
Kusho ukuthi uThixo uyabe phakathi kwaleyo nhliziyo.
You will have to ignore some of your thoughts.
Uyabe mele nje anga ayishayindiva futhi eminye imicabango yakho.
You will have to ignore some of your dreams.
Umele nje ashayindiva futhi eminye
amaphupho akho. Activities.
Futhi nokunye kwenza kwakho.
You will have to ignore them while he's seated there.
Umele kuyeke nje ehlele lapho.
Because he sits there.
Ngoba uhlala lapho.
Even at the time when you are angry.
Noma ngesikhathi uthukuthele.
He says no, we have made a contract.
Athi hayi lapha senze isivumelwano.
But rather he keeps fellowship with you even in the hardest.
Uyagcina ubudlelwano nawe noma futhi ebunzimeni.
Genesis he quit.
Ku Genesis waqhawula isivumelwano.
For him not to quit now.
Kodwa ukuthi angasiqamuli manje.
Because of the blood of Jesus Christ.
Kuke ngegazi lika Jesu Christ.
He doesn't see any fault in
you. Akasaboni kwehluleka
kuwe. You are justified, you have not done it in the first place.
Ulungisisiwe. Sengathi awuzange wona
kwaseqaleni. Assignment is against the devil.
Umlando wethu yikuthi simelane no devil.
Indodana
yomuntu yabonakaliswa.
To destroy the works of the devil.
Ukuthi izobhidliza umsebenzi
ka Satan. Assignment is to pull down the strongholds of the enemy.
Ukudiliza amaphila ka Satan.
By nature we are overcomers before even we are presented with something to overcome.
Yebo, singabanqobi singakaphiwa noma yikuphi.
Before you are given anything to overcome.
Ungakaphiwa kokunqoba.
You meet that thing as an overcomer.
Uhlangana nalokho lutho ungumnqobi.
Now by this I overcome.
Uthi manje
nothing but the blood of Jesus Christ.
Manje ngegazi lika Jesu Christ.
They overcame by the blood of the Lamb.
Banqoba ngegazi leyondlu.
In the words of their testimony.
Nangamazi obufakazi babo.
Our purpose is to prove that it can be done.
Isizathu sethu ikubonakalisa ukuthi kuyenzeka.
When other sisters are cutting corners.
Abanyodade futhi beshaya makona.
When other brothers are cutting
corners. Abanye
ama
brother beshaya makona.
God is raising a red species.
Uphakamisa. Eh imvelo eh
people who shall be created
abantu abazodalwa
who shall know their God
abazomazi uThixo wabo
Enoch walked with God
kuhamba noThixo
without knowing the seven seals
engazazi impawu ezisikhombisa
if Enoch walked with God
awu Enoch wahamba
noThixo before the blood of Christ
igazi lika Jesu Christ
if Enoch walked with God
ingekachitho Enoch wahamba
noThixo
amen
we can even walk faster with God
singahamba futhi sichithe ukudlula yena
we can walk longer with God
singahamba uma ngomude noThixo
if you walk with God
awuhamba noThixo
you can't walk with the world
awungeke uhambisane nomhlaba
you can't walk with the things of the world
awungeke uhambe nento
zasemhlabeni Jesus to this generation. Let the world see Jesus in you. You must be billboards for Christ.
There
must be a big billboard in
you.
That cannot be cut down. Which is you as a written epistle. Proving that a man can live so close to God. Until the devil doesn't know what to do with him. Don't put it to the millennium. It's happening now. God is recruiting his army now. I believe in practical Christianity.
Amen.
I believe in practical
Christianity. Ngikholwa isiKristu sentwezenzakala.
I was hearing a story that there was a Muslim.
Ebesizindaba yokuthi kwakule.
A Muslim.
A Muslim.
Who said Christianity is too hard to live.
Owathi yena.
Then there's a man who stood up and said, no.
Khona abaningi abaphakamayo bathi cha bo.
Christianity is easy.
IsiKristu silula
ndo. Says, come here, sir.
What is under?
Christianity is hard to live.
IsiKristu sinzima ukuphila.
Then he went for a heart cap. The man quickly remembered that I have to give him the other cheek.
Hey,
you don't be cheeky there. You must give him the other cheek. Then you see that Christianity is not about saying amen and jumping up and down. It's a lie. On Tuesday you are a Christian. On Wednesday you are a Christian. On Sunday you are a Christian. In your dreams you are a Christian. In the exam room you are a Christian. In school you are a Christian. Talking to your husband you are a Christian. When you are praying you are a Christian. Every time you are a Christian. Oh brother.
Oh msalwane.
One day you will discover
why
God has made you the way you are.
Like
the stones in Solomon's temple. They were fitting one another. There is no stone that was disqualifying the other. This stone was proving to the other why they have been next to each other. You could not run even a razor. There was no need for mortar. There's no need for a mortal being to even try and help when stone is connecting to stone. If there are people who say in heaven, if you had not gone, wouldn't be here. If you had not gone to help them and preach, they wouldn't be there. You have a divine assignment. You are anointed to become what you are born to be. Everyone is their defining moment. Sometimes it's a hard situation. David's defining moment was the time he met Goliath. When we came to this earth, we lost consciousness of who we are. But the power of sonship and adoption is back to us. You must step into your ought to be condition. Step into your adoption. When the bride shall know who she is, the rapture will take place. There is a reason why you are what you are.
So
I was reading some old stories about the football of insects. They say that insects were playing football. Then the other insects were losing about
5-0.
And then they brought a substitute. It was a millipede. And he scored about 10 goals in a short space. And people were wondering why it was not there all this time. Because it could take the ball to this foot and that foot you could not mark it. It had so many feet. It could not be defeated. It would pass the ball. So they asked it, why were you not here all this time? It took long for it to put all the boots.
What is cut song?
To come on the field. God can take long with you in the wilderness.
Then
we just hear a man coming saying, the X is laid in the root of a tree.
It took long,
for this man to be presented like that. So be patient with God. Your life must have impact. Even in your family, you must have impact. If your life has no impact even on your own parents,
Namfuzelelo nabazali bakho nje.
Your parents are complaining about
abazali bakho bayakhonona ngawe.
And we are busy calling you a brother.
Futhi wena wasibizi sikubiza ngomzalwane.
Your parents are complaining.
Abazali bayakhonona.
Your life must have impact.
Impilo yakho kumele ibe nemfuzelelo.
And people will say even if we disagree with your doctrine but we know.
Kuze kuthi abantu bathi hayi asivumelani nemfundiso yakho kodwa siyakwazi.
They are calling for you.
Khona izinga elobizo lingaphezulu lakho.
Discover that calling.
Amen.
There is a pressure of duty.
Kukhona uxinzelelo kumbe ngithi ifuthe
lomsebenzi.
Nga usedaweni yakho yomsebenzi.
And the Red Sea blocks you.
Ulwandle libomvu lukuvimbela.
Duty will create a way.
Umsebenzi uzovula.
If you're on your line of duty.
Nga usendleleni yakho yomsebenzi.
The sun is about to set.
Amen.
And you say, sun stand still, the sun will stop.
Lokho kusho ukuthi ilanga ima lizokuma.
If you are in your line of duty,
now usendleleni yakho,
and Jordan is overflooded,
uthi Jordan ugcwele uyaphuphuma.
Duty will open a way.
Umsebenzi wakho uzovula indlela.
If it is your duty to pray for the sick,
akukumsebenzi wakho ukuthi uthandazele abagulayo.
God will put healing in your hands there.
Uzobeka usilisa ezandleni zakho.
If it is your duty to plant churches,
akukumsebenzi wakho ukuthi uhlanyele ababandla.
God will put money in your pocket.
If it
is your duty to care for people,
God
will put kindness and patience in you. That's why the Shunammite God had to give them the resources. God will never call you to be something that needs another person to die for. No one must die for what you are. You must pay the price yourself to find your purpose in life. When duty calls. And there are no resources. If our missionary youth team starts moving. And you just let
me that go
there. It shall be given you what to say. You don't even need to meditate. You are a mystic to others. Because there is a divine pattern that is patterning your life. Like that old violin. It looked like it is a useless thing. It was so loose, its strings. It was so dusty.
Lumzimba wonke.
Bidders were saying, we're just saying, let this thing next item,
please.
Until the master came from the back.
And
said, this thing here, you, I know its potential. And he took the violin.
Violin
he could not present it before fixing it and restoring it. God cannot present you without first working on you according to your perfect picture. After that, there was stampede beating.
They said,
is this the same violin? Is it that same sister? Is it that same brother? Yes, the same person. But something has happened in their heart, brother. There's a shaping of a vessel. God is defining you right now. There's a reason why you pass through what you pass through. Your story is not over, it's going on. And whatever you pass through, positions you for the next level. If you look at a caterpillar, you think it's dying when it's spinning like that.
It
becomes like a hard, dead thing. It fasts for some days. Saying I've been too long in this mountain. But when that painful process is over, it says, fly away, oh glory. It starts flying. And when that has happened, you can't change a butterfly back to the butterfly. You can't go back to the old things anymore. Oh, there is a reason.
Why God has deposited what has deposited.
So uthixo abeke lokho akubeke phakathi kwakho.
That made in Naaman's home.
Lelo nina elisebenzayo endlini kaNaaman.
She was put there just to tell Naaman.
Leyo ncekukazi yabekwe endlini kaNaaman
ukuthi imshe. That is a court in Israel.
Uthi khona uthixo kwaSirayeli.
You were put at your workplace.
Ubekwe emsebenzini wakho.
So that one day you will speak the right words there.
Khona ukuze ukhulume amazwi amahle lapho.
There is a reason why you are where you are. Moses had no pressure when James and Jambres started performing.
He just said,
"I know my Lord will make a way." Father, when you are doing what you are called to do,
Salwani,
someone challenges you temporarily successful.
Engamelana nawe aphelele okwethutshana nje.
He sees the snakes, they are real.
Ubone sibili,
and people are laughing at Moses.
Ukuthi abantu bayamhleka uMoses.
Moses did not take it personal.
UMoses azange akuthathe nje njengento.
He knew what he was called to be.
Wayesazi ukuthi ubizelwe.
It was the Moses of today.
Ngabe ungumoso namhlanje.
He was going to look for rocks and say these things are false.
Ibeza dinga isitini athi into leza ngenza manje.
These things are false. I'm not kidding them. Moses says, no. What I was given, I've done what I was told to do. From here I committed to my master. It was now God to do the other things. There was a runner in Kenya there. He was very good and he was always winning the race.
Why?
But those who coach, they called him and said, look, you are always winning a race. But we have seen that when you are running. You lose a lot of energy doing this. That energy must go forward.
We'll
teach you how to manage your hands when you are running. So that all these
sides
and things go straight forward. You don't lose energy in things that have nothing to do with your body. There are some things that you must ignore. When you put your hands on the plow, don't look back anymore. Put your whole energy. Serve the Lord with all your mind and all your might and all your heart. And you please your master that is enlisted you as a soldier. There must be your scripture in the Bible. There must be a way of defying your background. There must be a way of defying your circumstances. When the prodigal son came to himself, it means he had lost himself. There are some people who have lost themselves. They have to come to themselves. He was then in his false self.
There are
some people who are living an unlived life by failing to be what God said they should
be.
God cannot waste ink writing your name in heaven when you are useless. Because God, when he writes, is not going to delete it. Forget names of angels and people,
popes
and cardinals and bishops and clergymen, and just look under the trees of
Luverne.
That spelling and Debele name there. And they start spelling a Shona Shupikani name there. There is a reason higher than what you are
present.
Don't live an unlived life. He says, what went you out to see? When you went to see John, it was not a reed shaken by the wind. When they asked
John
about his scripture, they said, tell us, who are you? What do you say about yourself? If I would take this mic and say, brother, tell us what you say about yourself.
You want to tell you
his brother can stammer like that. Because you don't know what you are here for.
Elila.
You say, John said, I am the
John voice. John
calling in the wilderness. If anybody asks you, that's who I am. Tell them I'm redeemed. What a drama, brother. Some of those people who sang that angel when the book was open, who sang that song that the angels could not sing when the book was open. That song that angels could not sing. Some of those people who sang that song, they were once carrying scars. Then they throw it when they saw the message. Some of them had nyoras in their bag. But what was important was that they were nyorot in heaven.
Even if
you come to Christ with all the leavens here, you have a part in Hebrews 11. They without you, they are not perfect. These brothers coming with things on their... They come with all those marks of Ndebele tribes and whatever. But brother, some come with tattoos here. And then we say, there's no condemnation.
But
to them that are in Christ.
But good lab about Christ.
The gospel says, come as you are, but don't stay as you are. But one thing to do, be yourself. Because no one will do that for you. No one will be yourself for you. I'm called to be me. I may help everyone I can help. But I help them as I am.
What
I am by the grace of God. If you are a preacher, don't copy other preachers. Do you know that all those old tales that were told by the Gogos, they are applicable even in Christianity?
We are to zonke ingane kwane sasitshelwa ngogogo ziyasebenza even nasesikristwini.
I was told that when the hair did some tricks and got some oranges,
ngatshelwa ukuthi umvundla athi ayenza amaqhinga athola amahala nje.
The baboon head, that what was done, you just go there and you lie
in ndwangu yezwa ukuthi kwenzakaleni lapha yabe ihamba la yalandela
khona
bayifaka enqoleni kopana babeyijika ama orange.
Then the baboon thought he can be what the other one is.
Baboon yasi indwangu yasicabanga ukuthi iyakwanisa ukuba yilo.
So, but the head warned and said, look, there may be tribulation.
And
they beat you about 3-4 times. When they think you are dead, they'll put you where the oranges are. Then you start throwing the oranges out. Then the baboon didn't know. He's not built like that one. When he was beaten badly, these things don't work. It's because of your approach. Your approach is being reproached. You are called according to the purpose of God. And all things work for good. To those who are called according to his purpose. Don't suffer as someone who is being beaten for being what they are not supposed to be.
Then
you start saying, God is just taking me somewhere. He's beating you for not being what you are supposed to be. Be yourself, my sister. Don't try to dress like another person. Why did God invest in making you? You must, even Daniel purposed it in his heart. That my diet is different from the Babylonians. Because I'm different. You don't even try to be like your pastor or my mindfulness or whatever. Don't even copy a hairstyle of somebody. Just be yourself. You are not called to be a drifter or a victim of circumstances or to have false comfort. But there is a dimension and a height and a level that you must reach.
Nengongo kumele ufike
kuyo. And circumstances cannot change you. Futhi
izimo angeke ziguquke.
If you are buried under heat and pressure, it's because you are down.
Xa ungcotshe ngaphansi kokushukuma nokushisa.
If you are crushed like a because you are a perfume, you are going to smell good.
Ah uvivinywa ngoba phela wena ungamakha akelelayo uzo.
And the adversity is God's university.
Futhi ukuvivinywa kuyivasithi likaThixo.
To bring you to your ought to be condition.
Ukukuletha esimeni okumele ube kini.
If you are a seed, you cannot be buried.
Uyintanga kumele
ungeke
ungcwatshwe.
When they bury you, you
ngabe sithi bakungcwaba.
They have put you in good position.
Sebekubeka endaweni elungileyo ukuthi umile.
I can see Joseph saying thanks to Potiphar.
Ngiyabona uJoseph esithi ngiyabonga Potiphar.
UmnoPotiphar uthi yini?
Qhubeka kanje lisenze.
You help me a lot again.
Ani yanceda Potiphar.
Thank you very much.
Kuzoba khona okunenge.
The adversity is God's university.
In Kwaleko, ye university.
I can see Goliath say, hey, brothers, if there was no Goliath, I don't know. I don't know
how
the ethics was going to work.
I
if there was no Goliath, I think by now I'll be heading sheep. And Hannah will be saying, if there was no Penina, I'll be still barren by now. There are things that are called to provoke you. Mordecai is saying, Aman, thank you before you die. Thank you very much. In the gallows there. Thank you, God used you mightily. When the winds are blowing hard.
Oh, easy, Mosifungo.
That's where the roots of the tree go down.
Yilapo impandes as that as Juna
call. When the streams and persecutions are coming your roots.
In
the message go deeper.
Impandes
and against all odds.
But in
a Christian shall overcome.
Christ uyanqoba.
You must be a better version of yourself.
Ele ube ngumuntu osesimene esingcono.
And the toils of the road will seem nothing. When you see a seed in the silos there, it can tell you its story. That in those days when I was starting in the message, some quails digged other brothers. In those days when we're still green in the message, some moth poured through the other brother. In those days when we were
born
in the harvest time, some baboons took other brothers. And he will tell you when I was now in the threshing floor, the ministry beat us. The evangelist beat us. They said we have never started. I saw brother Cope flying like that. And I said, I will stay here. I'm not going anywhere. Oh, brother, what you have passed through, it only defines that you are from God and you go back to God. Why is the temple so much in ruins? It's because a better version of the temple is about to be
a temple
higher than that of Solomon. The
Solomon.
The latter house. Why you are in hard times?
It's
because the devil is afraid of the next version of
you.
Do you know why there were barren women in the Bible? It's because the devil was afraid of their children. Sarah, the devil was afraid of Isaac. Rachel, the devil was afraid of Joseph.
Hannah,
the devil was afraid of Samuel. Sometimes you have this barren situation because what is coming forth. In Revelation 12, why the dragon is standing there. Before the woman is afraid of the child who is about to be born. Greater is he that is within you than the one in the world. You cannot sin because the seed of God
remains
in you.
In
other words, God is not going to withdraw
His
seed. When you have the seed of God, you have the seed of power. You have the seed of transformation. You have the seed of divinity. You have the seed of creative power. No matter how small that seed is, it has unlimited potentials. There is a big tree in that seed. In the olden days, the hard drive for a computer
was
as big as this speaker. They would put them in the big computer things. But now the thing, the chips that are controlling computers are very small. And you are also spiritually programmed to do the master's will.
God,
yes, invested a lot in your life. I'll read the quote as I'm about to close. The little ego did not know what it was born to be until the scream defined it.
And
it merged when the scream said, "Come up higher." The little ego said, "Not one more night in the
barnyard."
Enough is enough, I'm going. Higher and higher. Every one of you is mountain peaks of your life.
It
may not be seven peaks like the prophet, but you have your peaks of your life. But on that day, brother, when we stand upon the mountain
tops
so tall, looking over in that city that the Savior is preparing, it gives me faith that I will make it after all.
I've prayed
a lot that proves I will make it than seeing a lot that shows that I can't. I know I will make it. And I know you will make it. Do you know there were more chances of you not being you than chances of you not making it? But while you became you, it's because you are you. Unique. Yes. The quote says, but the power that spake the world into existence
is in those people
that have the Holy Spirit. That's right. Men and women, it's time we find out who we are. The devil is trying to hide you back and say, tell you are some little throw down something. You are not, you are sons and daughters of God. So that you shall be sons and daughters of God, you are now. Sometimes when people challenge you and try to disprove you, it can be frustrating, but you know who you are. When the prophet with that horse, that with a military prince, and there was another horse that was trying to just bump on that one, saying, "I'm also a writer." He just moved on like that. I remember the story of an
igu.
There was a race of birds. Which one can go highest? And the chicken, usually the wrong people are the ones who start. The chicken went
in
a noisy campaign. And it was so tired so early. And then the right people started saying, "Do, brother,
take the mic.
Then finally, after the climax was coming, the ego said, "This is my time." It went high, brother, one time. Without effort, it just went high like that. Then he screamed back and said, "I'm the highest bird." Then a little bird that was sitting on the ego says, "No, I'm the highest." This The ego was angered.
He
says, no, but I'm built for this.
It went high
again.
Yahamba yaphezulu.
And then it looked back.
Yasikhangela phansi.
And said, I'm the highest bird.
Yathi yimo ophezulu kakhulu.
That little robin said, no, it was robbing the ego there.
Okuyinyono obekuqili ingqonqono.
It says, no, I'm the highest.
Wathi yimo ophezulu.
The ego was angry now.
Ah, ingqonqono uyazonda.
Just said, this is a showdown.
Yathi lo ngumnqintiswano.
If I perish.
Yathi maku sisho ukuthi
ngife.
Ono ngife.
It just went one up there.
Yahamba futhi yaqonga kanjalo.
Then an explosion was heard.
Kwazwakala ukudubuka okukhulu.
There was a lot of blood on the ego.
Kwaba negazi eliningi lapha
phezulu. The little bird could not contain the pressure up there.
Inyona encane ibingeke imelane nesimo
esiphezulu. It was not built to be what it was impersonating.
Ayilungiselelwanga ukuthi ibe yilokho ekade izama ukukopa.
You explode if you try to be somebody else.
Uyadubuka ungazama ukuba ngomunye.
Just be yourself.
Woba nguwe nje.
The only way you can copy.
Indlela nje kuphela engcono ngakopa
manje. Because I also copy, there's someone I copy.
Ngoba kukhona nami kopa nami khona
ngikopa. To be like Jesus.
Woba nje ngothe.
On earth I long.
Emhlabeni ngiyazi.
All through life journey.
Ayindleleni yonke
empilweni. From earth to glory.
Eh kusuka emhlabeni
yenkazimulo. I only ask to be like him.
Ela nje kuba njengaye.
God is the final say in your life.
Thixo nguye onamazo okucina empilweni yakho. Phakama ngenyawo
zethu. You bring you to expected end.
Uzokuletha ekupheleni okukhangelelwe.
The expected end.
It's
not what people expect.
It's
what God expects of you. What God is expecting of you. The devil cannot disturb it. Your weaknesses cannot disturb it. Your past cannot disturb it.
Amen.
God will push his inherent potentials to make sure you shall be what you are born to be. I am what I am by the grace of God. So this afternoon, forget about yourself. Forget about your mistakes. Forget about your past. And press to the mark. There are greater heights and greater realms that you can reach as a child of God. You can discover the power that is already in you. Even as a sister, you have power to pray for the ministry. That was human.
No, Isifazana.
She just prayed and the revival came and she won Muti. And that was a million souls that were won through
Muti.
You can be a better version of yourself. It may be high risk but high returns. You must overcome your fears. Father, it is risky, but you must fight. Push away all the negative things. And put your foot there. And say, I'm there by the grace of God. It was not late for Moses. Moses wanted to put his foot in the promised land. And then he stood there and cast a wishful eye. When it looked like he was disqualified. In earthly terms, but in heavenly terms. Christ came on Mount Transfiguration.
They
said, Moses, you desired to stand here. Though you died, but we can still do something. Because they died in faith.
Glory.
Not having received the promises. But one day you will step into what you have believed. And that day is this day. In that day, you shall know as you are known. In that day, you shall know that I am in you and you in me. In that day, you shall ask everything. There has never been a day like this day. This is the day, my sister. This is the day, my brother, as we close our eyes. Each one pray in your own way. Pass through many scars of life.
Amen.
But there is a reason why you carry the pain. Saying, gladly will I toil and suffer.
Amen.
Only let me walk with thee.
Let us all pray.
Our Heavenly Father, we come to you this afternoon. As your children, O Lord, Father, something is encouraging us. Like Gideon was told, he's a mighty man of valor when he thought he was a defeated man. Father, we know something was deposited in us that will propel us. That is abstract title deeds, O Lord Father, that will make its way back to the throne. Father, I know that the toils of the rod will seem nothing Your children that were discouraged, may they pick hope again and be of good courage and know that God has already made a way because he has already predestinated us. He has already seen us through. Heavenly Father, may they pour the line of your spirit, O Lord Father, and of your message and scriptures. May those who are sick know that that sickness will go away all the same because by his stripes we are healed. May they know, Father, that in all things we are more than conquerors because all things work together for good to those that are called according to his purpose. May your children, Father, go and search for their adoption, their purpose in this life. May they never be drifters. May they never, Lord Father, follow other men, but may they follow Christ, O Lord Father, one step at a time. Though it's narrow, though it's hard, though it's painful, though there is a crack and though it's thorny, O Lord Father, may they suffer for the gospel. May they pick their cross and carry it all the days of their life. Because, Father, we know the suffering of this time is not worthy to be compared to the glory that shall be revealed in us. And that glory is already in us and is waiting for opportune time to be reflected, O Lord Father. We know, Lord Father, you have invested a lot in your children, knowing that, Father, that great finale, that grand climax of the gospel story is at hand, O Lord Father, when all nature has been waiting, groaning, waiting for the manifestation of the children of God. May we see, Lord Father, them stepping into their position, into their ought to be condition as your children, binding with the power to bind and unloose, binding the mama, binding sicknesses. Heavenly Father, this afternoon, Lord, I pray for those who are sick, for those who, Lord Father, we have burdens in their hearts, for those who are thirsting for a revival, for those who need another touch, for those who, Lord Father, who are sick and tired of their sickness, those who are saying, oh Father, they don't want to live in sin anymore, those who are saying there is a higher dimension that they can step into. Heavenly Father, as the word is calling them to come up higher, may your spirit ignite them, O Lord Father, that they may know it's not by might, it's not by power, but by your spirit, O Lord. Those who have come here for the first time, may they be magnetized by your word, O Lord Father, and believe that all things are possible to them that believe. May you anoint their faith, that they may be anointed to be what they are born to be. Because, Father, surely there is a purpose, there is a destiny, there is a calling for the people of God. That, Father, we must not listen to the voices of this world trying to hide us from the voice that is calling us higher. Father, we know the hills of hope are calling us. One of these days, O Lord Father, when the trumpet shall sound, we shall not be found again, O Lord Father. We shall rise to the heavenly dimension. Heavenly Father, I pray that a revelation will strike your people until the weak will say, I'm strong, and the poor will say, I'm rich. Looking at what God has already done, Heavenly Father, we know, Father, what you have called, O Lord Father, the work that you have started in us, you shall also finish it. I pray for a revival among your children. I pray for an awakening spiritually, that they shake themselves, O Lord Father, and know the things that are freely given to us, and know our inheritance. Let's not allow the devil, Lord, to rob your children spiritually, that they may live an underprivileged life, that they may live million miles below their privileges. But may they know that every promise in the Bible is ours, O Lord Father. Every chapter, every verse, and every line. We belong, Lord Father, to that family of God that Enoch belonged to. And we have the same spirit that was in Christ that shall quicken our mortal body. Father, I pray in this ministry that to raise men and women who shall know who they are and defy the economic conditions, defy all limitations, because we have untapped resources. We are not limited as your children, but Father, we have a fountain, inexhaustible fountain of the water of life. Father, we come, O Lord Father, as thirsty people to drink in those waters, that when a man drinks from, they are never thirst again. I pray, Lord Father, that everyone will purify themselves in the waters of life, O Lord Father, that they will be cleansed of all the thirst of the world, that they may be receive the Holy Spirit, O Lord Father, and get unction to stand and walk with God like Enoch walked with God. Father, I pray that to put a seal even in our youth, O Lord Father, to go with this gospel, not to just sit and watch, but Father, let everyone be a missionary, let everyone be a soul winner, Lord. Let us all be on the post of duty, doing what we are called to do. Heavenly Father, as we shall lay hands on a few people, Lord Father, who have burdens, O Lord Father, may those burdens be lifted. May your hand, that unseen hand, move from person to person, from heart to heart, and declare the impossible impossibility to be possible, and show that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Father, have your own way now, Lord. May you take us as we are in the potter's house and remake us again. May you pick the pieces of our broken life, our broken hopes, our broken marriages, our broken visions, our broken ambitions, and build us again, Lord Father, to the stature that you want us to be, oh Lord Father. We know it's never too late. Even when Moses was now 8 years searching for the Redeemer, searching for the pillar of fire, when he was 8 years, he met the pillar of fire. After running away for 40 years, Father, you met him, and it was not too late. You went with him, Lord Father, to fulfill his commission, to fulfill his purpose. We know, Father, every one of us, no matter how small, when the weakest of Christians begins to pray, there's confusion in hell. May everyone know their purpose and stay in their post of duty, because when duty calls, you are going to be there for your children to provide their needs.